February that morning.
December 1940. December 1940. About January, the 1940. But it's 40. You make it here, okay?
Ní àrùn ọdún 1940 sákòókò yìí ní gbogbo ọlọ́wọ́ bóyìí lọ sí gbé ìgbìmọ̀ yìí ní láti gbà náà àwọn ṣe ọ lọ sílé òwò
tọdọ
lọ sílé òwò ilé òwò rẹ.
Tọdọ gbọ́rọ̀ àbúkọ ọdọ mi ìwọ̀n mo ní oore ọ̀fẹ́ láti lọ sílé òwò abí mi nígbà èrè òbí bàbá mi ni late chief gabriel afunṣẹṣẹbàrẹ dìde ẹni gọfì. Bàbá yẹn wà lórí èyí nínú for 84 years. Not the age tó fi jòyè. He died at the age of 140 in 1994. My mother, late Janet Idowu Shagari, she passed on just open Odumaya sẹ́yìn. I can bet God bless you. She died 10 years ago. By this time of 10 years ago, we are celebrating our demise. And she died at the age of 104.
And your father died at what?
140.
140.
Yes.
So the two of them live long.
Very, very long.
Now, which primary school did you
attend? St. Philip's CAC Primary School in Rio here.
And your secondary school?
I went to modern school.
Okay.
After modern school, I went internally.
Okay.
I went for my, we don't call it GCE then. Unless I have something. Cambridge something. Labelle. Then I went for typing, shorthand, something. I did my RSA, stage 1 and 2. I was working at Ibadan. Formally, I taught Greenville. After that, I joined civil service. I worked in marketing board under the leadership of one late Mr. Yemi, of a blessed memory. He was a nice person, a friend to my husband. Later, I left the place for NCNC Secretariat. Working under the late lawyer Oluwole Ayinde, Ayinde Oluwole, a lawyer by profession. I was an operator, typist operator. You know, this telephone then, it's a quarter big something. You remove one plug to put for another one, or that call, you remove the plug to connect the something. So I was in that NCNC Secretariat for some time.
For the benefit of the younger ones today, what is the name of NCNC?
National Council of Nigeria, National Council of we have action group.
Okay. Nigerian Cameroon.
Something then.
Nigerian Cameroon Commission.
Yes.
So you work in the political area.
As a fact, the late lawyer Oluwole that I went with was the national secretary for NCNC. We had a office at Mokola Roundabout.
You know that one?
Yes.
Can I see your politician?
I did. As a fact, very, very well.
How was the politics then to now?
Then, it's really politics. What they are playing now is mono politics. Ask me why.
Okay.
I work then in political office, very close, a secretary to the national secretary of the party, local lawyer and really. Then again after that one, after the episode, I joined NPN. I was the woman coordinator for Ondo State. I still have my documents here. My photograph with late Akeleye, National Party Chairman. Shagari something here. I thank God. It was They are running to no politics. Now, there is no politics now. Then there was politics. If a leader tells you social body is coming, don't take a dime from him or her. We failed your hand. But now it is money everywhere.
Okay. Now, let me look into an area that is really agitating my mind.
Yes, sir.
Is it politics that destroy our culture, or our culture destroy politics?
It is politics that destroy our culture.
How?
Before, anything you say in Nigeria, they copy our leaders, people like Awolowo, Azikiwe, and Sadauna. But now, because of money politics that is in, it is the money politics that destroy our culture. In those days, when the younger one sees the elder, they will respect. But now, because of politics, you just get a guy doing nothing from just nowhere. He come with big bag of money and he started calling Babarere Babake. He can as well slap the face of his grandparents. It is these politics that destroy our culture. That's my own belief. It is my belief. It is politics. Nigerian politics. Why can't you be the guy? We respect elders. But these politics, we just say excuse out to order. We've been an appointment as a counselor. Within 3-4 months, he comes back, he started building a house. He's riding a car that a man who has sat for 31 years cannot ride. And you see, they know it is not right. But they start telling him, hey, you know what, man? They're telling me, can't come down. When those guys usually see those people with their affront and bandits getting a cloud from people, what do you expect them to do? It is politics that destroy our culture.
Let me take you back to the country.
Mm-hmm.
Were you able to travel out of the country?
Let's yes, please.
To study?
No.
To work?
To play. To see my children and to play. After the 83 election, because I was sacked, this house was reduced. If you see all these advertisements that was not painted, I left it for Mark. This house was attacked in 83. After the I was the woman coordinator for Ondo State. So they chased me out of this place to the glory of God. I am still living today.
Now, let's come to our culture and
mm-hmm.
Before the Western politics comes in,
mm-hmm.
we have our own cultural politics.
Mm-hmm.
How do we play our own cultural politics then?
Thank you, sir. To my own understanding, people have the fear of God then than now. You know, if there is no fear of God, there is nothing one cannot do. And there is no home training. Parents used to teach their children the way of the Lord, the way to live lives. But now, because of money, parents doesn't have time for their children. The children are dreaming, doesn't want to do anything before. Not to talk of when parents doesn't have time for them. All we are chasing is money. And at the end of the day, all the wahala everybody is doing, the children that doesn't have training are destroying everything.
Look,
mm-hmm.
I'm trying to look at our other politics
mm-hmm.
and our present politics.
Mm-hmm.
Who is better? I'm trying to compare the two together and let us look at it.
Mm-hmm.
Which one is far better? Is it our own politics or the Western politics we have?
So too. It all depends on what I'm doing and what I'm. We are centering the whole thing on what I've said before. In those days, the elder control, even in the Bible, you read in the Bible, the prophet will be the elder, it will be the chairman, the everything. In those days, there is respect, there is home training. Now, no respect for anybody, for your information. anybody, no other can challenge anybody now as you go home. If you know that it's challenging you all day, we will contend. Won't you contest it? We will contest it. In those days, yes is yes. Even in the Bible life. And that now, daddy, people don't take no for no.
Okay, so,
we met when I joined the police force. And after finishing my course, my parents doesn't want me to marry him. My late uncle, Reverend Adedigbe, was an elite person who understands life. He knows what he can do. I was 10, being 19. So he petitioned. Either the IG, I don't know him the right. But fortunately, I've done my personal parade at Kejabe so that I will not marry him. He's an indigenous figure of a blessed memory to the glory of God. I thank the Lord for what God's done in my life. So, I was no money. I got the patrol. They said, call me. This shadow is a so number. Send them there to see me. I marched there. Good morning, sir. You gave me the letter. Can you go through this letter? I went through it. This is a letter from your parents that you cannot marry the person who sponsored you, who wanted to marry me. He advised me like a father. And I agree. But I've made up my mind to do what I want to do. And I thank God for the children God has given me through the marriage. So when I went back, yes, that was when I went to work in marketing board.
So you left the police force?
Yes.
Was the police that asked you to leave or you left on your own?
I left on my own on the advice of the senior authority there. As a young guy, if they say, we don't want you to marry this your police officer or boyfriend, why don't you go and settle with them so that you can have a peaceful life?
Okay, okay.
Marital guys is my cup of tea. If you want to go to heaven, it is you that will decide to work for yourself. I will work towards it. Nobody can force me to marry my own love. They won't live my life for me. I explain to them. Later, they all became friends with my husband and me and myself. Without love, what help will come? Excuse me. It is not though. Every one of us might have had such an experience. If a girl is under menstrual pain and is seen to tell her that she loves, for your information, that pain will be relieved right away without giving any medicine. So it is worth talking of love. You can't make decision for somebody. It is easy to force and rest to the river. You can't force a drink. This is the person I love. If you are loving, I will enjoy my life with you. You can't force me to go and be enduring with somebody I don't love. So immediately I explain to them, I will remember. Will you go back to the police? I am no more going. Good luck, you don't send me there. So I made my own decision. That's why I went to marketing board to work. From there, I started attending, taking lectures, tutions. I did my LSA, and you know, stage one or two. You type in on shorthand, you know. It's moving with my life. To the glory of God.